number. He brought up Shanko, too. I know we have some callers. We'll get to him. He brought up Shanko, too, but he is questionable this week as well as Chester Taylor.
That's tough. Shanko is great for in touchdown leagues especially. If he's out, boy, there's going to be a lot of owners scrambling for tight ends. And at this time of the year, you look on the waiver wire and you see what you have for tight ends. It's spooky.
Mm-hmm. Well, I heard that he's going to play, but that he'll be less than 100%, which still, Shanko, less than 100% if he's on the field, is still going to be better than a lot of your other options at tight end. So if you have him, as long as he's playing, you know, keep him in there, hope for the best.
All he has to do is crawl in the end zone and wait for Mark to throw the ball. Just make it in the end zone.
That's all I'm hoping for in one of my leagues. 529-1450 is the phone number. Let's take another call. Good morning. You're on Fantasy Football.
Oh.
Let's go to this guy. Good morning. You're on Fantasy Football 101. Go ahead.
Yes, good morning. Love the show, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, got a couple of questions. I need a flex, and I've been playing Vincent Jackson, but he's kind of let me down. I've got Ryan Grant or Rashard Mendenhall.
Mendenhall this week.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Mendenhall this week's a great play.
Okay. And what about Flacco and McNabb are my quarterback, but Vince Young's out there. I heard you guys kind of talking him up a little bit ago. Do you think he could be picked up for maybe McNabb?
Stick with McNabb this week. Yeah, at Atlanta. Okay. Yeah, stick with McNabb. Actually, I'll tell you right now, Vince Young is my sleeper pick for the week, but I still don't like him over McNabb at Atlanta. So I'd stick with McNabb.
I'd take him over Flacco, but I'm like you, not McNabb.
Okay. Great. Thanks a lot, guys.
Good luck.
Yep. Thanks for the phone call, 529-1450. And, you know, as you prepare for the playoffs, though, if some of those guys are out there right now, it's not that bad of an idea to pick up a guy like Vince Young if he is available
not
in your league
all.
Because I have Carson Palmer and Matt Ryan as a backup, and I have very much been looking at another quarterback just in case because you never know what's going to happen.
I picked one up last week. I didn't really need one, but I picked up Alex Smith. He was still out there. And
well, you had to play him because Big Ben didn't play at the last second.
Yeah.
I noticed that. You were probably not happy with his move either. But Alex Smith had a decent day.
Yeah, he did.
529-1450 is the phone number. Let's take another phone call. Good morning. You're on Fantasy Football 101. Go ahead.
Hey, how do you guys police bad trades in your leagues? And the reason I ask is we had a couple teams. I traded Jay Cutler and Ted Ginn Jr. for Jim Sorge and Hakeem Nicks.
What?
And the guy turns right around. Yeah. And we called BS on it, but we only have to have three owners approve it, and they're all buddies, and they approve the trade.
Nah. You just have to have a commissioner then step in.
Yeah, you have to have a commissioner that'll just step in and
I've seen the league votes before, too, and that it just doesn't work. Like you said, they got their buddies, and they're like, yeah, whatever.
Like it or not, leagues need to be more of a dictatorship than a democracy.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, and you have to have somebody in charge that will run it and run it fair and that will veto anything like this that goes through. I commissioned two leagues, and I promise you that would never happen in either one of my leagues. I would not let that happen.
Well, they trade and drop, and then I think point totals 184 to 74, and it just... You know, and the other guy's alibi as well. I wanted Sorge because I need him as backup.
Nobody wants Sorge. No. Nobody wants Sorge.
I call BS on that.
Yeah.
Nobody.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah, you just, it's up to the commissioner ultimately. So, you know.
Do you have a waiver wire or can you guys just pretty much add and drop as you please?
We have four times, every 3 weeks we do a free agent pool type thing.
Oh, okay.
And guys get together and make trades. This was obviously a buddy trade.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, obviously.
Yeah, yep. You got to have one guy make all the rules. No more voting.
That's what makes fantasy football not fun.
And it sounds, like you, should, sounds like you should be that guy and nominate you.
Yep.
I agree.
I second that. All in favor of this guy?
Aye.
Yep.
All right, there we go. 529-1450 is the phone number.
Take care.
Thank you very much.
You.
Let's take another one, Nicarelli. 529-1450. Good morning. You're on Fantasy Football 101. Go ahead.
Yeah, hi there. I have to play, or I'm going to play, three running backs this week. I'm going to use a running back in the flex. Now, I do have Mendenhall, and I heard you guys mention before you're high on him.
Oh, yeah.
I need two more. My three choices are Hightower, Adai, and the lackluster Forte.
Points per reception league?
No points per reception.
Okay.
Hightower is questionable this week, I saw.
Is he? You know what?
Beanie Wells may be getting more of the touches in Arizona. Joseph Addai has been surprisingly consistent.
Yeah, he's
this season. He's I think you get him in for sure.
And Forte's playing St. Louis. This is an opportunity, one of the few times that Forte has a chance to really put up some decent numbers. I know it's scary, but with Hightower being iffy, I would go with Addai and Forte.
Yeah, okay.
And Addai might just give me more points throwing another touchdown pass, too.
You never know with Addai, especially when Indianapolis plays Tennessee. When these two teams play, there's all kinds of odd stuff that goes on. So you've got a chance with Addai to have some good points.
Should be a good game, too.
Yep. No.